Afgelopen weekend vond de 24e editie van het North Sea Jazz Festival plaats. Vandaag en morgen kunt u nog kijken naar twee concerten. Vandaag het concert van saxofonist David Sanborn en zijn band. Sanborn maakt al jaren een crossover van jazz, funk en blues. Behalve dit swingende concert ziet u ook een kort interview met hem.
Joe Zawinul in the background, I get a chance to talk to David Sanborn, who just got off the stage. David, a wild hot stage and a hot show too, with great extremes, very intimate moments also.
Yeah, I mean, what I like about playing Europe is the audiences tend to be a little more sophisticated, and you can kind of play a much wider range of material than you can really get away with in the States. They tend to accept more, and, you know, especially, I mean, you can see on a festival like this, there's such a wide variety of artists here, you know, every possible description musically, you know. I mean, the stretching the limits of the definition of jazz, which I think is great, which I think that's the way it should be, you know. So it's a big umbrella.
You did a project, a CD called Inside, with a lot of recordings you did in your home.
Yeah, I did a lot of it in my house. I didn't intend to do that. I started out just with the idea of like kind of doing demos at home, and I kind of liked the way that it started to sound, because it really represented kind of the way I was feeling at the time, just kind of things very natural and without a lot of effects. And I also think that I got a more offhanded aspect to my playing, because I wasn't really thinking about, you know, being under the pressure of being in the studio. And it's, you know,
one of the things that struck me on that CD is that the way you recorded the saxophone, it is like you're standing next to someone, like next to me. You hear it is, and this is the way I sound.
Yeah. So either you like it or you don't. Pretty much that's it. You know, I like that quality. I mean, a lot of it stems from my kind of, you know, preference for people's demos, because this is what I do for a living, you know, and a lot of my friends make records as well. I get a chance to hear people's demos before they're like mixed and all the, you know, the reverb and all the mixing and balancing and stuff. And I tend to really like the rawness of demos. There's a real immediacy to it, and there's a kind of set of production values that's prevalent now in like hip hop music, that where it's very unaffected, very kind of dry, and it sounds almost like demos, and I kind of like that.
If you wake up in the morning and you see your saxophone, what do you think?
Well, I usually don't sleep next to it, so lately I've been trying not to think too much about the instrument, because at least for me at this point, I'd rather think about the music, and if I get too focused on the saxophone, it's easy to get into the technical aspects of the instrument. I'm a long way from ever mastering the instrument, even coming close, but I think I'm just going through a period now where it's better for me to not be around it. I still practice, but I don't do it as obsessively as I used to. And I find that sometimes when I've been away from it for a while, I come on things by accident just because I haven't played. And I think that's really a useful way to kind of get to other parts of your mind, you know, the creative process that you wouldn't ordinarily get to. Because you kind of, you know, you master certain things, and you have a tendency to kind of go for what you know. Whereas if you haven't played for a while, you don't have a lot, you know, you're kind of just searching. And sometimes in the course of that searching, you fall on things that you wouldn't, you know, if you were had maintained a level, you know. It's just, it goes in cycles, you know. So I think it's always going to be that way, but it's that way now.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Ricky Peterson, Tom Barney, Sonny Emery, Don Elias, and Dean Brown. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you, North Sea. Thank you.
Thank you.